I'm Cherry.
I'm Peter.
And I'm Lucy.
Wow, guys, there's so many people here today.
Yes, I see that. What do you think is going on?
Well, I heard that someone extraordinary is here today.
Oh, I wonder who.
Well, we'll find out. Let's go meet him. With only 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish.
I know, right? But did you know that some of us here today does not know Jesus? How about if we introduce Jesus to them through our praise song?
That sounds like a great idea.
Boys and girls, would you like to join us in our praise?
Sky.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Those of you who are sitting down, let's all stand and rise and sing together, everyone. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so pleasure in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven.
You came from heaven to earth to show the way from the earth to the cross. My death to death, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way from the earth to the cross.
Let's all sing, Lord, I lift your name on high.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us.
Let's clap loud, as loud as we can. Ready?
What's the matter, Peter? Are you okay?
I just love Jesus so much. I am so grateful for what he has done for me. Did he really die for my sins? I don't think I deserve this much love.
Oh, Peter, of course you deserve his love. God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, Jesus, who died for our sins. And whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
That's right, Peter. Why don't you stop crying and tell our friends again how much God loves us?
Sure. I have a song in mind that talks about God's love.
I think I know what it is.
Me too.
Hi, friends. Would you like to join us in singing our following praise song?
Yes, let's give our praise to God who loves us so much.
Let's all sing L-O-V-E, love.
Everyone, boys and girls, let's all rise, reach our hand, and let's sing L-O-V-E.
Come on now, let's open up the book. Come on now, and take a good long look. And see, God has given us all we need to be free.
It's about you!
It's about you! It's about me. It's about the truth that sets us free.
It's about L-O-V-E, love from the Father above.
It's about hope. It's about life. It's about the love of Jesus Christ. It's about everlasting, never failing love.
Come on now, everyone.
Come on now. Let's open. Come on now.
that we have friends who came to church for the first time today. Don't you want to meet them?
Of course, I would love to meet them.
If today's your first time at church, will you please raise your hand?
Yes, please raise your hand so that we can see you.
There they are. Welcome to our church. Wait, Peter, why did you want to meet them again?
Oh, Lucy, Jesus loves everybody in the room. It would be a pity if only three of us knew about his love. Don't you want to share God's love with everybody here?
Of course. Oh,
I think I can explain Jesus' love better than anyone in this room. You see, when you have someone that you love, you can't take your eyes off that person. Like this.
Oh my, Lucy, Peter, what are you guys doing?
Lucy, why are you chasing me?
I'm trying to explain God's love to you. You see, God never leaves us for a moment. He waits for us to come to know and believe in Him. And whether we are happy or sad, He never leaves us alone. Like this.
I get it, Lucy.
Lucy, that was a good one. Now I can clearly see how God never leaves us and is with us. That reminds me of a song we can sing together.
What is it?
The title is It's So Good to Know.
I love that song. Let's all sing it together.
All the boys and girls, let's rise and sing together.
I would never be lost. I won't be all alone. You found me, saved me, made me your own. I would never be lost. I won't be all alone. You guide me, change me, on my way home.
Everyone said it's so good to know.
It's so good to know.
Go to your right,
to the right, to the left.
Turn around,
straight ahead. You are always with me, Lord.
If you're sitting down, let's all stand, sing together.
I will never be lost. I won't be all alone. You found me, saved me, made me.
Got it. And to all the boys and girls, it was nice meeting you tonight. We will miss you, but I'm sure we will meet again at church.
That's right. And after we sing our final song, I heard we have a fascinating performance coming up. Aren't you guys excited?
Yeah, I can't wait. Well, remember, boys and girls, God is always with you. Let's sing our next song together.
이 시간 우리 어린이들, 엄마들, 아빠들 다 일어나서 우리 함께 같이 찬양할게요.
I won't turn left and I won't turn right. Will not stray from the path that's right. Keep on seeking.
Well, good evening, and one more time, welcome to this amazing Fall Family Festival. Man, hasn't this been an incredible event? Wow. My name is David Laughlin. I am from Denver, Colorado, and I'm an illusionist. So I just want to check real quick. How many of you know what an illusion is? Okay, how many of you do not know what an illusion is? Okay, how many of you did not raise your hand for one of those questions? Because it is one or the other. Either you know or you don't know, but just in case you're here and you do not know, I can explain. You see, sometimes you might think you're seeing things that you're not actually seeing, and sometimes you might not see a few things that you really are seeing, and any of those times you do see those things that you don't see, or that you don't see the ones that you do see, that is an illusion. Does that make any sense? Not really. Maybe I can explain better. In fact, I brought something along to help me. I brought along this card. Now, on the front side of the card, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spots. On the back side of the card, there are 3 spots. Now, there will be a test, so you have to remember the first side has 6 spots, the second has 3. On the third side of the card, there are 4 spots, so don't forget about the third side, or the fourth side of the card where there's 1 spot. Does this make sense? Okay, one more time. 6 on the first side, 3 on the other, 4 on the other, and 1 on the other. But here's the thing, you see, this is an illusion. Maybe I can explain. When I hold the card like this and I tell you there are 6 spots, something happens. What happens is your mind tells your eye that there must be a spot under my hand, but guess what? Yeah, there's not really a spot there. If I cover up this part and tell you there are 6, you might believe there are 6. If I cover up the spot and say there are 4, you may think there's only 4. Does that make sense? So when I cover up this part and I say there are 6 spots on that side of the card, that is what I call an illusion. And that's what all of you call lying. But now you know the truth. Hold on, we have our microphone making some noise, I think. Now you know the truth. Like that it looks like 6, like that it looks like 4. On this side I might tell you there are 3. How many are there really? Some of you are pretty quick. There are just 2. Like that it looks like 3, like that it looks like 1. Does this make sense? Okay, I'm not sure it's totally making sense to all of you. We'll review real quick. How many spots on this side of the card? Do you remember? Right, 5 spots on that side of the card. Although sometimes your mind will tell your eye that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spots. In fact, sometimes the same thing happens over here. I might tell you there are 3, and you might stare long enough, you start thinking there are 3 spots on that side. Is this making any sense? That's okay. It does not make much sense to me either, but one thing I have figured out, the more I turn this over, the more people keep seeing spots. And sometimes when they see that, they even clap their hands for whatever reason. I'm not exactly sure why. Now, some of you heard that, some of you don't, but in a moment, I'm going to need somebody to help me out. Now, a couple things. If you want to help, sit all the way down. Raise your hand up nice and high. I need somebody to come up on the stage and help me with something a little different. We have a room full of incredible volunteers. I'm gonna make my way right down this way, see if I can find somebody to come up here just a little bit. So many incredible volunteers, but how about, do you wanna help me right here? I just need one. Just one, yeah, come on up, come on up. You'll be perfect. Make your way right up here to the front if you can, please. Excellent. What is your name? Faith?
Grace.
Grace. Grace, step right about here. Face somebody out there. Smile big and take a bow, buddy. Please give Grace a round of applause. Grace, hold tight for just a moment. I have one more thing that I'm going to need. Grace, you're really gonna love this. It is way back here, but we're gonna bring it just a little bit closer. Grace, something kind of interesting. Grace, you're gonna help me with a fun little experiment. Grace, I have a couple questions for you. Grace, step right back over here for me, please. Right there. Excellent. Grace, first question. Have you ever wondered what it would be like to float in the air? Grace, would that be amazing? It would be amazing. Well, Grace, guess what? Tonight, right now, Grace, we're not gonna do that, okay? That's not what's gonna happen. Because Grace, I'm guessing you'd be brave, but just to be honest, if Grace was like floating around the room, I would be kind of afraid. I would not know what's going on. So Grace, we're going to do something different. You see, one of the things I've learned is we sometimes have to look at things differently. Now, the other day I was home in Colorado, that's where I live, and my daughter, who's 6 years old, was in the yard, and she found something, Grace, that I thought, this is so amazing. When I go out to Virginia, I'm going to bring this along. Everybody would love to see this. And so, Grace, I brought it along. It's on this table in this box. It has its own little carrying case. The amazing thing that I brought along to show all of you tonight is this. Grace, this is a feather. Okay, I know. Typically, that's not very exciting. But here's the thing, Grace. Most people would look at this and think it's not that amazing, not that interesting. It's just a feather. But like I was saying, sometimes we have to look at things differently. See, my six-year-old daughter didn't just see a feather. She said, but Dad, watch the way that it almost seems to float in the air. When we saw that, it gave me an idea for something different, something that with your help today, Grace, this could work. It's something a little different and somewhat unusual, something that I simply call lighter than air. Wasn't the good part, all right? I'll try to do a little better. Grace, wait right there. Amazing, some of the amazing and incredible things that can happen with normal everyday objects in the right hands. In fact, it kind of reminds me how when we put our lives in the right hands, in God's hands, He can do some awesome things in our life. And people often ask how I got started doing these tricks and illusions. The truth is, when I was the same age as some of you guys here today, my mom and dad gave me my very first box of tricks, my first magic set, so to speak. And I loved it whenever anybody would come to my house and I would show them whatever the latest, greatest trick was that I've been practicing. Now, some of the first tricks that I learned were a little bit different. In fact, one of the very first tricks that I ever learned was a trick that used my dad's handkerchief. Okay, some of you aren't sure what this is. Sometimes people put them in their pockets to look nice. Other times they take them out of their pockets, blow their noses in them, and then put them back in their pockets. I know, but this one's clean. So here's the idea. What you're supposed to do is begin with a simple handkerchief like this and then kind of make a fist with your hand, make a hole like that. You simply take the handkerchief, push it down into your fist and squeeze it nice and tight. And if you do this correctly, it's possible that an illusion can be created. That illusion is that that simple white handkerchief slowly changes to red. In fact, even today, that same thing can begin to happen. As it goes into my hand, it becomes a little less white, a little more red, a little less white, a little more red, till after a while, it might almost look as if the entire white handkerchief changes to red, just like that. Now, I'm sure most of you have probably heard the rule that I'm not supposed to tell people how I do the tricks. Have you guys heard that rule? How many of you like that rule? How many of you would rather learn how to do one trick today? Would that be okay? Well, I figured this is a special night. This is a perfect night to do this. I'm going to teach you how to do the color-changing handkerchief trick. There are a couple things you have to know. Number one, to do this trick, you are going to have two handkerchiefs. Yeah, some of you already had that part figured out. One more important detail. When you find your two handkerchiefs, make sure that they are different colors, or else it's not an amazing trick. Couple of the details. One is the preparation. So to begin, we're gonna set one to the side. The other one you're going to hide down inside your fist. Remember, normally you wouldn't let everybody see this part. This is what you do ahead of time when nobody is watching. Simply take that white handkerchief, push it down into your fist. Make sure it doesn't start poking out the bottom. That would ruin it. Push it all the way up from the bottom, all the way down from the top. Be sure you practice ahead of time and that you're sure it fits down inside your fist. Now, once you kind of have it down inside your fist, you just wanna kind of stand in front of a mirror or ask a friend. You guys look like great friends. So how am I doing? Does it look like it's fairly well hidden? Okay, it apparently does not. If it is not fairly well hidden, just make sure you make whatever corrections you need to make. Just make sure you get it all the way down inside your fist. Then you pick up your other handkerchief, and now we can start the trick. So at this point, you have the red one in one hand. You have the white in the other. It's okay if people see the red one, but they should not know about the white one. So what that means is do not accidentally open this hand. And you guys understand why you should not open that hand, right? Okay, why should you not open this hand? Because they'll see the white one, yes. Thank you for paying attention, exactly. If you accidentally open that hand, everybody will see the white handkerchief. It'll fall on the floor, totally ruin the trick. So once you hide it inside that hand, keep it closed and don't open it. Does this make sense so far? Okay, we'll just explain a little bit more. So once you have that one hidden, all you should have to do now is take the red one and poke it down on top of the white one. So remember, if you earlier we hid the white one in our hand, that way all you have to do now is reach up and pull the white one back out. Which is just the one that you put there ahead of time, if that makes sense. So you create the illusion. It becomes a little bit less red, a little more white, a little less red, a little more white. You slowly create the... Okay, leave the last part out. Don't pull this one all the way out when that one is sticking up, or else it becomes pretty clear that there are two. Now, if you make that mistake, here's what you can do. Take one of them and just kind of get rid of it. Put it off to the side, and then take the other one, push that one down into your fist, squeeze it nice and tight, and just do your best to create the illusion that it changes from a red handkerchief into a white one. Does that make sense? Just a little less red, a little more white, a little less red, a little more white. After a while, it might almost look as if the entire red handkerchief changes to white, and if that happens, it will look just like that. And now that you all know how to do that trick, I am going to need a couple more people to come up here and help me out. Let me see if I can go the other direction this time. Remember, if you want to help, sit all the way down, but raise your hand up nice and high. So many fantastic volunteers. I'm going to start over here, and I need two people to come and help me out. In fact, do you want to help me, sweetie? Follow me if you would. Come this way. Come this way. Come this way. We're going to find somebody from a little bit further back. And let me see. Do you want to help me, buddy? Come on up this way. We're going to go this way. You two will be amazing. Perfect. Two fantastic volunteers. Make your way right up here to the front. Yeah, come on up with me if you would, please. Awesome. Come on all the way over here. You are going to be incredible. What is your name? Elaine? Aline. Did I say that right? Aline, come step right over here for me, please. Aline, right over here. Awesome. Right about there. And what is your name?
Mark.
Mark? Mark, you're going to stand right here. Okay, well now Mark and Aline, face somebody out there. Try this. Ready? Take one arm. Ready, Mark? Ready, Aline? Put it in front of you like this. One arm in front. Take the other one. Put it behind your back. Yep. And then bend over like this. Take a bow. We all please give Mark and Aline a big round of applause. Now, Aline, take a half step closer. Come right about here for me, if you would. Please, just a little bit closer. Awesome. Now, we wanted today to be so much fun, and I was walking around, and I saw, man, there were so many activities. You guys were, like, riding a mechanical bull and get your faces painted and on bounce houses. I mean, awesome things. But there's one thing that I don't think you were able to do that you probably wanted to do, and it's everybody's favorite thing. And so, Mark and Aline, you guys are going to do this right now. In fact, you guys probably guessed what it is. Right now, these guys are going to take a test. Because we all like taking tests, right? That's your favorite thing to do in the entire world. It's... Okay, hold on, hold on. Mark, do you like taking tests? Kind of. Aline, do you like it when you take a test? Do you like that? No. Okay, well, I hope they like this test. It's a different type of test. This is a test that has to do with colors. Because I was thinking about colors and I started to wonder who says a color is what it is. You ever thought about that, Aline? Let me explain. For example, who named this red? Do you know, Mark? Yeah, I don't know either. Now, I know God created that color. Someone decided that in one language, we call it one thing, and another thing. And in English, the word we'd use is red. But Aline, I don't know who gave it that name. So Mark, right now we're gonna change the name to blue. Aline, hold the blue one. Now Mark, I'm gonna give you this one, which right now we're gonna call yellow. Hold on to the yellow one. And Mark also gets this red handkerchief. Hold on to that with your other hand. And Aline, that leaves you with a beautiful green handkerchief. Here you go, Aline. Hold that in your other hand. One in each hand. Perfect. Now here's how the test works. You guys are gonna turn and face somebody out there. Take one in each hand. Hold it down by your side. Now, when I say a color that one of you is holding, as fast as you can, you have to take that color and raise it high above your head. Now, you guys can't help them, but if they get it right, you gotta cheer them on, okay? So we're gonna test this out. When I say one of your colors, raise it high above your head. Face somebody out there, smile big, and raise the yellow handkerchief up in the air. The yellow handkerchief. The yellow handkerchief. Give Mark a big round of applause. Okay, place that down by your side and raise the blue one up in the air, the blue handkerchief. No, the blue. Aline, you have the blue. The blue. The blue handkerchief. There it is. Give Aline a big round of applause. Place that by your side and the green one. Raise the green one up in the air. The green. Remember, that's the green. That's green. That's good. And the red one. Raise the red one up in the air. The red handkerchief. Okay. Now, Mark and Aline, you guys are going to be amazing. Don't forget the colors. Remember, you got red, yellow. Let me see your colors. Green and blue. We're going to go a little faster and do more than one color at a time. Everything else is the same. Aline, if I say one of your colors, as fast as you can, hold it high above your head. Mark, if I say one of yours, as fast as you can, hold it high above your head. So hold them out in front of you like this. When I say your color, raise it high in the air. Let's begin with blue and yellow. As fast as you can, the blue and the yellow, the blue and the yellow. Raise them up in the air. The blue and the yellow, the blue and the yellow. The blue and the yellow. The blue. The blue. Blue. The blue. The blue and the blue and the yellow. Give them a round of applause. They've got it. Place that by your side. How about green and red? Green and red as fast as you can. The green and the red. The green and the red. The green and the red. The green. The green. The green and the red. The green and the red. They're doing amazing. Place that by your side. How about this one? How about blue, yellow, and red? That's three this time. The blue, the yellow, and the red. The blue, the yellow, and the red. Okay, let's try this. How about red, green, blue, and yellow? That's all of them. Raise them all up in the air. Let's hear it again from Mark and Aline. Okay, I tell you what. That part was tricky. But you guys still passed. And so what that means, Mark, is there is a second part. Isn't that fantastic? Okay, here's what I need you to do this time. Let's go ahead and begin by placing the yellow handkerchief down inside the back. Put the yellow handkerchief. Excellent. Go ahead and put the blue one in there too. And the green one. What color's left, Mark? Yeah, I forgot too. Just put it in there. That'll be easier. Now here we go. We're going to shake this up really good. When I open the bag, come a little bit closer. When I open the bag and a nice loud voice, tell us the first color you see. You ready? Come a little closer, Mark. A little closer, Aline. Here we go. One, two, three. Okay, one more time. When I open the bag, tell us the first color you see. One, two, three. All right, hold on. We might have to remind them of the colors. Here, Mark, just take yours. Wait a minute, Aline, take that. Hold on a minute. Mark, what did you do? Take that. Mark, start walking that way. Aline, start walking that way with yours. Yeah, keep going, Aline. A little further, Aline. A little further, Aline. Keep going, Mark. A little further, Mark. A little further, Aline. A little further. Yeah, keep going, Mark. Just watch where you're going. A little further, Mark. A little bit more. A little bit more. Yeah, keep going, Mark. A little bit more. Yeah, just keep going. Keep going. A little further, Aline. You go that way. A little further. A little bit more. A little bit more. I don't know exactly what Mark and Aline did, but they definitely passed our test with flying colors. Will you guys please give Mark and Aline another round of applause? Aline, come on back over. Mark, come on back this way. You guys were absolutely incredible. One of the prettiest messes I've seen in a long time. Watch your step there, Aline. Just one more thing I need you guys to do. Face somebody out there. Mark and Aline, put one arm in front of you, one behind your back. Take a bow. Will you guys please give Mark and Aline one more big round of applause? You guys can head on back to your seat. You did an amazing job. Thank you, Mark and Aline. Wow. In fact, I have to say, they were amazing sports helping me out with that. And I saw some of you guys were hoping to get a chance to get up here too. So one last time, I think I'm going to need one more person to help me out. But real quick, before you raise your hand, I have to tell you, this is going to get a little bit crazy. Slightly silly. So if you're like, nah, that's not me, you can put your hand down. But if you think, hey, I might be down with that, then you can raise your hand. I need to do something just a little bit crazier, a little bit sillier. And yes, I am going to need another person to help me out. I think we should kind of make our way toward the middle this time. Let me see if I can find somebody willing to come up here and have some fun. Let's come back just a little bit further in here. Do you want to help me, buddy? All right. What is your name? Elliot, make your way right up here, please. You're going to be fantastic. Elliot, come all the way to the front. Elliot, join me right here. Face somebody out there. Smile big. Take a bow. Everybody, please give Elliot a round of applause. Elliot, I have a question. How old are you?
Seven and a half.
Elliot, that's amazing. That is exactly how old I was when I was your age. I was seven and a half. And it was around that time I started learning these tricks and illusions. And so, Elliot, I had this great idea. I thought, what if I could have someone like Elliot come up on this stage and help recreate what it might have looked like when I was seven and a half and I was learning these tricks. So, Elliot, wait right there. I gotta grab something. You see, I brought something along just for you, Elliot. It is right back here. I think you're really gonna love this. Elliot, I have this box, and it is full of some amazing tricks and illusions right here. In fact, let's take just a little bit of a step forward. Awesome. Oh, we gotta lower this just a little bit. And there we go. That's gonna be better. Elliot, oh, one more thing. See, today is a day that we kind of really act the part a little bit. We saw Superman up here. We've seen some other crazy things. And so, Elliot, when I was your age and I started learning these tricks, my mom made for me my very own custom-fitted magician's costume. So, Elliot, today I brought along for you your very own magician's costume. Now, Elliot, I got to make sure it's the right size. Put your arms in front of you like this. Perfect, and I'm just going to place this over your shoulders. Yeah, we're just going to try this one on. Look at that. It is a almost perfect fit. Doesn't Elliot look fantastic? Now, I know Elliot looks amazing, but what Elliot is about to do, I think you guys are really going to love it. But for this to happen, we got to give him some encouragement. Could you please give a huge round of applause for our special guest, the amazing Elliot.
When your body, a wink of your
shakalaka. Shakalaka to the dance shakalaka. I said a boom shakalaka. That's a brand new style. A wicked say the wicked cha-cha. No say a while.
Wow. Elliot, you, my friend, were absolutely incredible. Stay right there for just a second, because Elliot, I told you I needed somebody willing to come up here and have some fun. You were definitely the right guy for the job. Put it there, man. In fact, Elliot, you did such an awesome job. I know there's a chance that later on people might see you and they say, aren't you the incredible, amazing Elliot who was up there on the stage doing some tricks? Here, step right over here from everybody. And you're going to say yes. But then they might want to see a trick. So I have something for you, Elliot, for doing such a great job and kind of having a little extra fun. Elliot, you get to get one of these. Okay, I know it doesn't look that amazing, but sometimes we have to look at things differently. Elliot, check it out. This is a lightning wand, because as quick as lightning, it appears at your fingertips. I'll show you how to do it. You just simply open up one side, tuck it into itself, roll it from one side to the other. This is the most difficult part of the entire thing. But Elliot, once it's all the way rolled up, take that in your hands. Face somebody out there. Smile big. Toss it in the air. Catch it. Oh, fantastic job, Elliot. You are amazing. In fact, Elliot, back here, buried in here, we have, there it is, the instructions that go along with it. That is for you, Elliot. And yes, all of this applause is also for you. One more time, let's hear it for the amazing Elliot. Thank you, my man. You can head on back to your seat. You did awesome. You know, I love to do these tricks and illusions to have fun, to smile and laugh and have a good time. And obviously tonight at the Fall Family Festival, we hope you guys have had an amazing time. But there is truly a reason we can come together, we can smile, we can laugh, and that is when we know what life is all about. See, I've shown you a number of different tricks and illusions, and all these things are just illusions. But there is one thing you can know is true and real, and that is that Jesus does love you. And he has an amazing plan for your life. That is the truth that you can hold on to, that you can know is real. In fact, today I want to tell you a story. And like any good story, it's important to start in the beginning. Now, in the beginning, when this world was created, I was not here. You were not here. But God was here. In fact, today, this purple piece of cloth will help us think of God. You see, purple is the color of royalty, the color of a king. God created this world. He was and he is king over all of it. He made the mountains, rivers, oceans, trees, flowers, animals of all kind. But then, God did something extra special. God made people, me and you. In fact, not just us, but every single person who ever has or ever will walk upon the face of this earth was created by God. Today, this red piece of cloth will help us think of people. You see, we as people, we were created different than any of God's other creations. We were created in the image of God. It was his desire for us as people to experience a close, solid, tight, unbroken relationship with him. That's what God wanted us to experience. He wanted us to be close with him, to be tight with him, but there's a problem. See, the problem is that we've all done something to ruin that. We've all let words come out of our mouth that we knew we shouldn't say. We've all done things that we knew were wrong to do. Those type of things we are told are called sin. See, the truth is that all of us have sinned, and because we have sinned, we've been separated from God. That perfect relationship we were created to experience has been broken. It's been ruined. In fact, not only have we been separated from God, but there is now a penalty that we have to pay, a price that we owe for not being perfect. In fact, we are told that the wages of sin, the price that we owe for not being perfect, that price is death. Now, some people hear that and they say, well, wait a minute, David, that doesn't really make sense. If none of us are perfect, if all of us have sinned, and if the price we owe for sinning is death, why are we all alive? That's a fair question. So let me tell you what this does not mean. This does not mean that if you go do something later tonight or tomorrow that you shouldn't do, or you say something you shouldn't say, and you sin, you'll immediately die. That's not what that means, thankfully, for all of us. So what does it mean? See, it's not that we immediately face a physical death, but it's a spiritual death. And I know that can sound confusing, so hopefully this picture will help. What that simply means is that our sin has now come in between we as people and God. And as long as there is that sin in our lives, there's nothing we can do by ourselves to fix that problem. We will forever be separated from God because of our sin. And if that was the end of the story, it definitely would not be a very good story. But thankfully for us, that's not the end, because there was one person who was different. A person like me and like you, a person who walked upon this earth and was tempted to say and do things they shouldn't say and do. But this one person never gave in to that temptation. One person was perfect. And that one and only person was Jesus. Now, I don't know if Jesus really looked like this. It's just a picture we sometimes use when we talk about Jesus. But he truly was the only perfect person to ever live. But even though Jesus was perfect, there were some people who didn't like him. In fact, they hated him so much they began to spit upon him, to beat him. They nailed him to a cross, and they killed Jesus. In fact, after Jesus died upon that cross, they went a step further. They brought his body down from the cross and began to do something. They began to wrap it in some burial clothes, which simply were some strips of cloth in which he would be buried in. They placed Jesus' dead body inside those strips of cloth and did one last thing. They took the entire thing and put it inside a tomb, which was simply a large hole in the ground in which a great big rock or stone was placed in front to keep it closed. And at that moment, I'm sure some people thought this was the end of the story. Jesus was dead. He's in the grave. The end. But it wasn't the end. You see, on the third day, some people came to that tomb. And you can imagine how surprised they must have been when they noticed that the stone placed in front to keep it closed had been rolled away. As if by a miracle, someone had simply reached down, picked it up, and set it aside. They looked inside that tomb, and when they did, they saw something truly amazing. You see, what they realized was that Jesus' body was no longer there. The amazing truth is that Jesus loved us so much, he died on the cross for our sins, but he did not stay dead. He rose from that grave, and it's only because of that that our picture can be changed. You remember that picture that we as people were separated from God because of our sin, and I told you there's nothing we can do by ourselves to fix that problem. Because of what Jesus has done for us, there is a way. In fact, Jesus said it like this. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No person comes to God but through me. See, that is the real reason we can celebrate. That's not just what today is all about. That's what life itself is all about, is knowing that Jesus has an amazing plan and purpose for you. And I know some of you are here today and you've heard that message of Jesus before, but for some of you, that was the first time you heard it, or the first time it made sense. I'm going to invite you to pray with me right now, and after that, Pastor Daniel is going to come up and close us out. But I'd love for you guys to close your eyes and bow your head. And if you are here today and you've never made that decision to accept Jesus, I would invite you to just say a simple prayer with me. You can just say, Dear Jesus, I know I'm not perfect. I've done things wrong and I've sinned. But thank you for loving me, for dying on the cross for me, and for rising from the grave. Today I accept you. Come into my life. Forgive me of the wrong things I've done. And teach me to live for you. In Jesus' name, amen. You guys, if you are here and you have made that decision, you have prayed that prayer, I want to encourage you to talk to some of the leaders here at this church. They would love to celebrate that with you, to help you know what those next steps are. This is an amazing place that you can tell is full of people who love you. In fact, can we give these people another huge round of applause? Miss Tina, Mr. Daniel, and just more people that I can know for making this amazing event happen. I hope you guys had a lot of fun. I'm going to turn things over to Pastor Daniel again. My name is David Laughlin. God bless you guys. Thank you.
Yes, I am an angel. Thank you very much. Hey, brother, that was wonderful. That was a wonderful presentation of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Let's give God praise one more time for our brother. Man, I hope you come back again next year. Yes? Next year? Yeah. Praise the Lord. Hey, everybody. I just want to introduce myself real quick. My name is Daniel Kwan, and I am one of the pastors here at KCPC, at our church here. And on behalf of our church in place of our senior pastor, who is currently away at the moment, I would like to welcome all of you here at our church. And I also want to thank all of you for coming out to our festival here today. And so at this time, I'd like to once again give God praise for this wonderful festival. Let's give God praise, everybody. Big round of applause for our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And so actually, it's been 3 years since we had this Fall Family Festival, obviously because of the pandemic. But by the grace of God, we were able to have this festival today. Now, I know many of you are part of our church. I can see many faces that I recognize. I can see many faces here that I recognize, obviously, and those of you here as well. But I also know that not all of you are from our church. I know some of you are from other churches, and I thank God for that. But I also know that there are some of you here today who are not part of our church or part of any church. More importantly, I know that there are some of you who may not know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, who Jesus is. And so I'd like to take this opportunity, this time, to invite all of you brothers and sisters, all of you guys, to come to our church. Our church has worship on Sunday. And by the way, our worship is not only in Korean, but we have worship in English. And we also have worship for all ages as well. So you can be a little baby then you can be very old as well, but you can come to our church and join us in worshiping our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Now, you saw many people here today. As I told you, I've seen many people I know. Also, if you don't know this, our church also has Captain America as our church member. We also have Spider-Man as our church member. But let me tell you right now, Superman and Captain America, these guys are superheroes, but they are not my superhero, and they are not the greatest superhero. I have a superhero. Do you have a superhero? Who is that superhero? Hallelujah. Praise God. I'll tell you right now, Jesus, who is my superhero, Jesus, who is my hero, not only comes to our church, he resides at our church, he is the head of our church. And so here tonight, I know that the world is celebrating Halloween. We're celebrating Fall Family Festival because we know that Jesus is our King. Jesus is our Savior. Can we give God praise for that? Praise the Lord. And so, once again, thank you all for coming. And I hope to see not just some of you, but every single one of you, those who obviously come to our church, but also those who are not going to a church, those who don't know Jesus. You heard the gospel today. And so come on over. I'd like to see every single one of you here on Sunday morning. All right? And with that said, I'd like to pray for us. And so if you can pray with me, if you can close your eyes and bow your heads, and I'm going to pray. May the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the everlasting, unconditional love of our Father in heaven and the wonderful work and ministry and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be upon all of your sons and daughters here tonight, especially be upon those who still need to know you. Lord, be with us not only today, but from now and forevermore. Amen. Praise the Lord!